I'm Izanne Roos. I'm a neurologist at the Royal Melbourne Hospital as well as at Eastern Health in Melbourne. I work as a clinical neurologist with a special interest in MS and neuroimmunology. I'm also a postdoctoral researcher at the University of Melbourne. The most fun fact and the most extreme thing I've ever done is moving to Melbourne. I'm originally from Durban, South Africa. I moved to Melbourne in the beginning of 2018 to do my PhD focusing on MS research. I'm usually someone who likes to avoid too much change and unexpected happenings, but this is something I really wanted to do and I'm really glad I pursued that. Being a clinician who also does research in MS means I have the insight into the person living with the condition. I know what's important to the individual. I know what is affecting their everyday life. And I'm involved with those treatment decisions real time on a personal level. On the other hand, I also have an opportunity to be able to distance myself from that on occasion and look at the big picture and being able to use data from a large number of individuals to inform the individual patient in front of me's treatment choice. Approximately 6% of patients with MS develop disability at an accelerated rate. These patients require a walking aid within 10 years from their first symptom onset. It is, however, uncertain how we can tailor treatment selections for this specific patient group so that we can reduce their risk of significant disability accumulation. What I propose to do in this study is we want to look at early high efficacy therapies in this group of patients at high risk of early disability accumulation and see whether or not that treatment approach reduces their long-term risk of becoming aggressive MS. So this research will enable both the patient and their neurologist to tailor their treatment choice very early on after their MS diagnosis to enable them to have the optimal outcome and the lowest chance of disability accumulation in the long term. This will certainly help maximize a patient's chance of having a life without disability, improve quality of life, and prolong employability. I think that these are exceptionally valuable things to be achieved. I would sincerely like to thank the donors and researchers who make this MS research possible. Without this type of support, research such as this would not be a possibility. Researchers are oftentimes dependent on this type of support. And our people living with MS would certainly benefit from it in the long run.